without your smart mouth, drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so...
Quetta Barnes, this is your husband-to-be. We in here getting ready, man. I can't wait to see you walk down that aisle. I haven't seen you since yesterday. All my people's here. We getting ready for you. I love you, baby. It's our time.
And I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you.
Hey babe, it's me, your beautiful bride. I cannot wait to meet you at the altar so we can spend the rest of our lives together. Look forward to seeing you. I love you. See you soon.
My end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind, 'cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you.
The days and the weeks and the years will roll by. For you I'd give a lifetime of stability. Anything you want of me. Nothing is impossible for you. There are no words or ways to show my love or all the thoughts I'm thinking of. Cause this life is no good alone. Since we've become one, I made a change. And everything I do now makes sense. All roads end, all I do is for you. For you I share the cup of love that overflows, and anyone who knows us knows that I would change all thoughts I have for you. There is no low or high or in between of my heart that you haven't seen. Cause I share all I have and am. Nothing I've said is hard to understand. All I feel deeper still, and always will. All this love is for you. Every note that I play, every word I might say, every melody I feel are only for you and your appeal. Every page that I write, every day of my life would not be filled without the things that my love for you now brings. For you I make a promise of fidelity, now and for eternity. No one could replace this love for you. I take your hand and heart and everything, and add to them a wedding ring. Cause this life is no good alone. Since we've become one, you're all I know. If this feeling should leave, I'd die. And here's one. Cause this life is no good alone. Since we've become one, I made a change. And everything I do now makes sense. All roads end, all I do is for you. For you I share the cup of love that overflows, and anyone who knows us knows that I would change all thoughts I have for you. There is no low or high or in between of my heart that you haven't seen. Cause I share all I have. Nothing I've said is hard to understand. All I feel deeper still, and always will.
I found love in you, and I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. I found love in you, and no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. And this is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me.
For this joyous occasion. Amen. DJ. Thank you. God's word tells us in Ephesians chapter 5, beginning at the 21st verse, and a few of the following. And give thanks for everything to God the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and further submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. For wives, this means submit yourselves to your own husbands as to the Lord. For a husband is the head of his wife as Christ is the head of the church. He is the savior of his body, the church. As the church submits to Christ, so wives should submit to their husbands in everything. For husbands, this means love your wives just as Christ loved the church. He gave up his life for her to make her holy and clean, washed by the cleansing of God's word. He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church, without a spot or wrinkle. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies. For a man who loves his wife actually shows love for himself. No one hates his own body, but feeds and cares for it, just as Christ cares for the church. And we all are members of the body. As the scripture says, a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united into one. This is still a great mystery, but it is also an illustration of the way Christ and the church are one. So again, I say to each of you, you must love Brother Joseph, you must love your wife. Sister Marquetta, you must respect and reverence your husband. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come thanking you for this time, this privilege, this opportunity that you have allowed us to gather together for such a time as this. We're here to encourage, to pray, and to add our blessings upon the life and the journey that is before Brother Joseph and Sister Marquetta. We ask that you will be a lamp unto their feet, a light unto their pathway. Be with them as only you can. This is our prayer in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, we're here. Our Heavenly Father, it is blessed the two of you all that your paths have crossed and you have chosen to share your lives together from this very moment. And love has and always will be the richest and the greatest gift to the world, a love between a man and a woman, which matures into marriage. And today, as you two come to celebrate and to exchange your vows and to also join your families together, it is everyone in here's deepest desire, the well-wishers, the onlookers, and yes, even the freeloaders, that you all will be richly blessed and that you would enjoy your lives together. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God, amongst family, friends, loved ones, to give recognition and again encouragement to the work and the beauty of marriage. To add our blessings in the words that will unite Joseph and Marquetta together into matrimony. For marriage is a difficult journey. I know I should get some witnesses out there. It is not something that you should go into lightly or unadvisedly or just playing around with. Marriage is an honorable estate. It is created and instituted by God. And it is the perfect union again between a man and a woman, and therefore it brings glory to God. At this time, who gives this bride to be married to this man?
I do.
If you would need your name and your relationship.
John Burns.
And you are?
Red Father.
Anthony Fenneman. Godfather.
Amen. You gentlemen, you gentlemen's work is done. You may be seated. It is a joyous, wonderful, and truly a privilege to have your grandfather and your godfather to be a part of this ceremony, especially on the doorsteps of Father's Day. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And certainly they have given their blessings, they have poured into your lives, they have done all that they can do within their physical power to shield and protect and to keep you. But I'm also wanting to charge the both of you, as you will one day answer to the true and the living God. And that will be the day that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that all personal, private, and even secret things that we have done, we will have to give an account to God. And so I ask at this time, is there anything that you all need to state at this time to share with one another? Any reason that you feel like you can't move forward? Brother Jeff, is there any reason today you can't move forward? He said, this ain't Vegas. My question, is there anything you you'd like to state or share any reason why you feel you can't move forward? Amen. Amen. And so today is a good day, because it's the day that the Lord has made. And God has blessed us with the greatest gift, the gift of love. The love between a man and a woman. And that all again present here today wish the both of you the very best that life has to offer. Joy, happiness, that your marriage can experience together as you are going to share the rest of your lives together. But you need to be reminded to not be confused with worldly love, because the love of God is unconditional. And so you have to learn to love one another, to protect one another, be patient with one another, and certainly to forgive one another. Joey and Quetta, life is given to each of us as individuals, and love is given to us and proven and shown to us by our families. We learn to love by being loved. But learning to love and living together, that's a whole new experience. Even when you find that you don't like one another, your love will still conquer those difficult days. And as you travel through life together, I caution the two of you on this exact moment that you all continue to be there for one another, have one another's back, continue to do everything you possibly can to support one another. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Joseph, will thou take my Quetta to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of marriage? Will thou love her, cherish her, protect her, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Aquella, will you take Joseph to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will I love him, honor him, cherish and protect him, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him as long as you both shall live?
Oh, I did
it. All right. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would continue to instill wisdom, knowledge, understanding. Thank you for the exchanging of words and vows at this moment. We ask that you would continue to show your life and your glory in the life of Joseph and the life of my Quetta. Be with them, Heavenly Father, as only you can. And then we ask that their life of husband and wife will be an example, just as your word says, that you will let their light so shine before men that they may see their good works but glorify you, the Father, which is in heaven. This is our prayer. Your son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The rain. These rings are going to be a symbol to let every woman out there know that he's already taken. This ring that my Quetta will wear We're letting every brother know that she's already spoken for. Joe, today you receive a special favor of the Lord, because God's word in Proverbs says, he that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor of the Lord. So you're now being promoted to have something that you didn't have as a single man. You have special favor that God has given you. Amen. And for Marquena, we certainly don't want you to feel that you're left behind. Because for a husband to take upon his wife, that means that you have a priest, a provider, and a protector. That means that you no longer have to worry about anything, because your husband, you're taking on leaving father and mother. You're leaving your grandfather and your godfather. All of their responsibilities now are shifted to him. Whatever you needed in life, whatever they did for you, if you need something now, he's your responsibility. Be faithful to one another. Wear the ring in honor of one another. When you go work out at the gym, if you don't want to wear it, get your workout ring. Can I get a witness? You don't want to wash dishes in it, get you a dishwashing ring. What am I saying? When you put it on, keep it on. Amen? Amen. Because it is honoring one another when you are out of one another's presence. And it reminds you that your love and your commitment that you are sharing with one another on this day. Take her left hand. And you can place it halfway over to up the finger, halfway. Say, with this ring, I do wear in the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Son.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. You can push it up. Taking this one off. With this ring.
With this ring.
I do wear.
I do wear.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit. I want you all to join hands at this very moment, because I want to read something for you. And even as you are joined hands together today, it is to encourage the both of you that each and every day of your life that you are joined together. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love, that holds yours on this wedding day. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your future together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and care for you throughout the years. These are the hands that will hold you at the time of grief, but with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will give you strength when you struggle, but support and encourage you to chase down your dreams. These are the hands that one day will hold your grandchildren and keep your family together as one. These are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, and yes, even tears of joy. And lastly, These are the hands that, even when wrinkled with age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness, just as a touch from these hands. Amen. The family has chosen to do the sand ceremony, and we're going to ask that they will come to the table at this time. All right. The sand ceremony is a representative of two families coming together as one. And it is certainly a joy, but it's also a physical reminder of this day, that 5, 10, even 25 and 50 years from now, you will look back and be reminded of the two becoming one. And Joseph and Marquette has chosen to include you all in this ceremony because you all are and always will be a part of their life. Amen? This sand represents the foundation, the judgment of God, that everything that we do, we should always put God first. Matthew 6 and 33 says, "But first seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things shall be added." Okay, Joseph, your color, I believe, is blue. Blue.
It says a question of the heart.
Red.
Red.
See, y'all can tell they family, they already fighting.
It don't matter.
It's all
that.
It's all that.
Just pour half. You're pouring your color first because you are the head of this family. And we certainly want you to be your foundation, to be on the word of God and trusting in the Lord with all of your heart and leaning not into your own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. Marquetta, you can choose your color. As she pours her color of sand upon yours, that means that she is trusting you. She's going to trust you as you trust God. She's going to follow you, just as you follow God. The leadership, the example, and certainly the foundation that you are building for this family. Then we're going to ask.
Kiara,
you choose your color. As being the firstborn, this is also bringing you into the covering of the family. Okay, then the next.
Patrice.
CJ.
Now we're going to ask that Joseph and Marquetta will take their sand and pour it together as they are blending, asking for God's blessings upon their children. That the children will pour the rest of their sand, that they will follow and honor their father and mother, the Lord leads and guides and protects them. Amen. Amen. And I am truly honored and blessed. But just before we ask that you salute your bride, I want to present you all with your very first and the greatest gift you can ever receive on your wedding day, the Word of God. This is priceless. 10 years from now, every gift that you receive, it would be either too old for it or it would be too old for you. The money that you receive will be gone this time tomorrow. But this word will last. Somebody said today. Heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will remain. And we've had it engraved with your names on it, so that you all can have your own personal devotional Bible together. Now, by the power invested in me, the privilege and the honor extended to me as the pastor of Perfect Peace Baptist Church, Reverend John Donahue, I now bless you all as husband and wife. You may salute your God. For each and every one, this is a great occasion and a celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Britt. While they were getting it together, we certainly did want to thank all of the guests, the family, and friends. Come on, let's celebrate this bride and groom again. This is a special, special day, and all of the family and certainly loved ones and certainly those that know the challenges of marriage. All right, go right ahead.
Bring them out, bring them out, bring them out, bring them out. It's your mother.
First up, we have Rose and Victor. We have Stephanie and Carl. We have Shamara and BJ. We have Devasha and Marvin. We have Mr. and Mrs.
fellowship and the gathering of this celebration. We ask that you will bless this food for the nourishment for our bodies for Christ's sake. This is our prayer in His Son Jesus' name. Amen.
There we go. Okay, so we on video, guys. Now, y'all gonna train into it. Take your time. Take your time. You on video. Make sure y'all smile at the same time. There we go.
$100
you just made. Yeah.
There we go.
There we go.
There we go.
some energy. With some energy. Oh my God. Some energy. Oh, there you go. There you go. All right.
I can't stay away. Too long. we got to go and call them out, Joe. Call out the rest of the single guys. Say Brandon. I said Brandon. Brandon, I don't know who you are, but they called you out. Joe doing one more stroll around. Stop hiding in the corner, man. Unless you done signed that piece of paper already, you still single. They don't recognize common law in Indiana, y'all. So it's gonna hit this dance floor. Ain't no common law in Indiana. So go hit this dance floor.
There's Terrell back there too, Joe.
Y'all shouldn't have to tell them each other to get them to the dance floor, man. Y'all got the groom out there making people get up.
Ah!
Yeah. know your name, so how can we get together?
Call on me,
I had to speed up. Y'all was handling it a little too well, so I sped it up a little bit.
Oh, and the reason for it all, but I am the part of it all. I love